my sense of music and art in general is that it's an act of empathy. Hello, my name is Lembit Beecher. I'm a composer, and I've written a number of works dealing with aging and dementia, most recently an opera called Sky on Swings. When I started working on this project, the thing that I knew I wanted to do was to portray the world, the interior world of these two women who have Alzheimer's. And there's the two main characters, Martha and Danny. In the end, the piece is a bit of a love story. They meet each other at this facility and rely on each other. I mean, there's so many stories one can tell about Alzheimer's, but wanted it to be about their experience, the two women with Alzheimer's. And I think that's one thing that music can do very well, because there's this magic, you know, people are singing, there's these crazy sounds going on around you. And it's also letting characters speak deep from the heart of things. They can sing what they're feeling or sing what they're experiencing. And it's easy for the audience to enter that world. One thing that I hoped for this opera was that everything that the two women with Alzheimer's would feel would make sense to the audience emotionally. Because the idea was to live in Martha and Danny's minds and to be in that place where everything keeps slipping through your fingers. And that sense of, oh, I should know what that is, but it's gone. The other thing for me that was important was that the chorus was sometimes threatening and they're sometimes antagonistic, but also sometimes quite beautiful. And especially when Martha and Danny are able to stop trying to remember, when they're able to just live in each other's presence. And when no one's telling, do you remember this? There is something that's sort of comforting and not unbeautiful about the sound, the sort of buzzing of the chorus. To that extent, opera is sort of the perfect medium for telling a story like this, because even when words, this outward ability to express or words fail, I think we have this understanding that the interior life doesn't, and that those emotions are very present. I played with language a lot, and Martha's character in particular, who's more advanced than Alzheimer's, and she moves from singing more complete sentences to singing a lot of mumbles like the chorus around her, these sort of gestures, and sometimes those will move sort of fluidly between them into text and then back out again. She does a lot of humming. She has certain sort of little vocal gestures that she keeps coming back to, which is something that I observed with some people with Alzheimer's, sort of relying on these vocal patterns that don't rely on words. Once I began working on this project, I'd have all these conversations with people, and as soon as I'd mention Alzheimer's, they would say, oh, and then I would just sit down for the next 30 minutes because they would have a story to tell me. And some of these were people who I knew quite well. Suddenly they had this opportunity to talk about this thing that they hadn't really talked about before. And I think stories, these vast shared experiences that don't get talked about in the public sphere in the way that other diseases are. And I think with Alzheimer's in particular, where every case is so different and where everyone's experience can be so different. I don't know what has made me so interested in aging. I think I'm interested in human experiences, and I think like a lot of artists, and I think all music does such a traditionally good job of expressing, you know, romantic love, things about grief or a death of a loved one. But there isn't so much about aging. And I think I'm particularly interested in works of art that really focus and center the experience of older people and their relationships. And we're not comparing that life to a younger person's life.